Welcome to Laya Swada, Taste of Rhythm, an exclusive performance-oriented series on Laya concepts in Carnatic music. Being in Laya is something locking together when we are performing in whatever aspects of music. It's with respect to melody or math or rhythm. So today we have Vidwan Shri R. Kumaresh and Vidushi Srimati Jayanti Kumaresh taking us through a journey on how they perceive Laya in both melody as well as math.
Namaskar. It gives both of us, Kumaresh ji and myself, immense pleasure to be a part of the Samatva Foundation instituted by the wonderful, multi-talented, brilliant percussionist Guru Prasanna and his family.
It's our pleasure to be part of this beautiful series, Laya Swada.
So the word Laya is a very cosmic word. Everything in this cosmos has to be in Laya. When you say Laya, it means in sync. Many people confuse Layam for Talam or Rhythm. It is that, but it is something more than that. It is very significant that we are recording this on the day of Mahashivaratri, the Damaru of Lord Shiva, which creates and takes care of the entire cosmic action. That day, we are recording on Layam. What can be more beautiful? The breath that we take, one breath, another breath, the space between that is called life. The heartbeat that we have, the space between one beat and another beat is called the life. When I am speaking, the space between one word and another word is called life. Only through the life of my speech, you will know if I am calm, or if I am agitated, if I am in a hurry, if I say, I am in a hurry, or I am very calm. So the layam of these two things are very, very, very different. Everything in this world, from our walking, to our eating, to our thought process, the layam between the mind, body and the soul, to be in sync, to be in cadence, to have that measured space between one action and the other action is called Layam. Only when you are in sync like this, there is a beautiful Layam to life.
This has been very beautifully encapsulated by the great Maharishi Yajnavalkya. He says, Japa koti guno dhyana, dhyana koti guno layaha, laya koti guno gana, Ganat Paradaram Nahi. Meaning, being in Laya, being in sync on one thought is equivalent to koti koti times doing japa. And singing or being musical is beyond Laya, meaning you dissolve yourself and become musical. In our tradition and culture, we announce practice of music as Nada Upasana. So you become one with Nada. When it becomes Nada is the point where melody and rhythm becomes one. Only then we have something called as a composition. A melody is complete only when there is Swara and then the Thara. Swara and Thara. Swara is in Laya, Thara is in Laya. Shruti Laya. That is what it means. So, this is a beautiful platform to share with you our little what we know about music and Laya as the way we perceive it as musicians.
When there is a musician with an instrument, his manolayam and the layam that he has with the instrument has to be in sync. In this context, there are two of us. the mano life of the two of us has to be one. For instance, I have a plan to play a composition. I want to know, Kumaresh ji is in the same line and is going to say the same composition. What composition shall he play?
I am in trouble. Dharmavati?
He says Dharmavati, and that's exactly what I wanted to play too. So,
escape.
The sink is called line. Now, we may be in 180 speed, we may be in 90, we may be in 100, but even in that 100, when two people are playing, the pace could be a little faster for one, could be a little lagging behind for one. So to bring in that center point where we are in sync, not just musically, but in our thoughts, that is when did the co-artist, the mridangam, the ghatam, the violin, the veena, when everything is in line with the shruti, in line with the rhythm, in line with thought, in line with action, magic happens. Now the first thing we do is when we sit down, what is the tambura? What shruti is the tambura, we think? Tambura, we say, now it is tuned to E. You close your eyes, you switch on the tambura. If the tambura is in da 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 da, look at the line of that. It's a bit restless. It doesn't allow you the space to calm down and create something. Immediately you say the line of the one string between the other string is too fast. Can we change the line? Na, na, na. That's too slow. So, finding the right line. Da, 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 da. There is adjustment in each tanpura, be it electronic, be it digital, be it actual tanpura, to change the speed in which we strum the strings. So once you have that in the right line, your mind is tuned to that tanpura. Next comes tuning of the instrument. Now, how to tune in laya and how to tune not so much in laya, Kumaresh ji will demonstrate.
See how beautifully they have codified different words in our traditional system, like shruti, like laya. When you say swara, see there is that word of vara in that. When you say shadjam, see such a beautiful word. Shad means six, jam means that which gives birth to the six. So when you say sa, shadja, sa gives birth to the other six. Shruti means listening also. So there all these words have a very deep meaning too, and they actually signify what they are, what they actually define. So when she says layam, and when you are talking about layam, shruti, you listen and then you get to dissolve yourself into that. So let us see if we are going to be in layam when tuning shruti or a layam. When you want to dissolve yourself into something, you go like this.
Instead, you change the laya of tuning. much of tuning, in so much of line in tuning, how much line should be there in a raga alapan?
When you are going to play raga alapana, we have to first understand that we are filling up silence with musical melody. When we speak as a language and you want somebody to understand, if you speak very fast, half the song doesn't reach the other person's ear. Similarly, if you talk in a monologue, that also won't be interesting. So when you express your emotions through a language, through dynamics, through pauses, through full stops here and there, you make the entire conversation very interesting. Similarly, when you play alapana, you are introducing a raga. You are getting to know a raga. It is a conversation between you and your instrument and the musical melody and musical structure, musical notes of a raga. And all that sound you are going to communicate to an audience. So when it comes to that, you need to be in a different state of mind. Unless you become that raga, whatever you are going to express is not going to be complete. Get there, you need to dissolve yourself. That laya into the raga has to happen. We'll check if the laya happens or not.
Changes. It's like what we radiate into the cosmos, the same thing comes back.
Thank you. Thank you.
actually did not speak about this earlier. So the lion has to be in such a way that he knows exactly what I am going to do, and I know exactly what he is going to do. I know he will play the other Ganesha. So that is the Mano lion. Like this, there are so many small aspects in which lion manifests and makes us in sync.
See, in the concert platform, not only us, we have percussion artists also along with us who are part of the team. And it is so important that all the four of us are in the same line, same thought process, so that reflects on the way the music reaches you, and that reflects on the way you appreciate what you listen to. So Layam, that way a dissolve of all the musical minds happen. So now we are going to play a composition in this raga Dharmavati in a rhythmic cycle of 8 beats, which we call as Adi Taram, also called as Chatushira Jati Triputa Taram. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So since we are playing on an instrument, we are going to create a composition which is very instrumental, so that we can play the space, we can play with the melodic meter. So since there is no lyrics, we can fix our climaxes the way we want to. How do we want to phrase the introduction and the finishing of the introduction, all that. For example, we are starting with five, six, seven, eight, that kind of a combination. And to show that we are finishing the first line, so you know that the first line is ending there, and also the edupu where we are starting the composition. And then as we finish the composition, we have created a climax which we call as Puruttam. Puruttam means something that is similar sounding. That is the beginning of the composition. So the climax will sound very similar to. So similar sounding, which is beautifully called as Puruttam, meaning similar. Right? Is that the correct translation for it?
So the entire theme is going to be takadinatam takitatam takitatam takita.
Right?
So the first syllable alone is given carve, where the takita is kept straight. Like for ta da da da. Then the sentence ends with.
Thank you. Academy, so what we are doing, adding one syllable to the first letter. Takadimi, Tadimi, Ta Tadimi, like that we are doing. So many beautiful possibilities are available for us to explore through the prism of math and melody. We call it MNM. Now that we have finished the composition, we thought we will do something called as a Kharagpur. What is a Kharagpur? Kharagpur is a bunch of notes arranged in sequences, rhythmic patterns, all adding up to one particular number. So let us take 32. We have 8 beats. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And each beat interval is 4 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 7, 2, 3, 4, 8, 2, 3, 4. So we have 32 counts in this 8 beat set. So we take the number 32 and do rhythmic patterns or rhythmic sequence, which we call as Kharagpur. For example, let us take 1, 2, 3 as an option. Just 1, 2, 3. What is 1, what is 2, what is 3? So 1, 2, 3 can be 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Right? 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Okay, we have 32 as a number. So using this 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1 pattern, how do we reach 32? Okay, let us take 5. 5, 1, 5, 5, 5, 2, 5, 5, 5, 5, 3, 5. So 1, 5, 2, 5, 3, 5. What happens? 5, 2, 5 is 10, so it's 15. 3, 5 is 15. 15 plus 15 is 30. So we have got 30 now. Yeah, but the cycle is 32. So what we do? 1, 5, 1 gap. 2, 5, 1 gap. 3, 5, we are in position. So for example, let us 5 be taka takita is the syllable for 5. Taka takita, 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 taka takita. So if you play melodically, it will sound so beautiful. That is how it sounds musically. So now that we did with 5, we will take another variation. So what happens, instead of 5, we take the number 3 and put it in the same pattern. 1, 3, 3, 3, 2, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3. So 1, 3, 2, 3, 3, 3, 3 is 18. How? 3, 2, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 6. We have 6, 3. 6, 3, 6 into 3 is 18. So the total cycle is 32. Oh, no, we have got 18. We need 14 more to go to 32. What do we do? In between, we had 2 sevens. 1, 3, 7 gap. 2, 3, 7 gap. And 3, 3. There, the full space is beautifully painted with the melodic swaras of Dharmu. Seventh, If 6 plus 3 is 9, then 5 plus 4 plus 5 is also 9, right? So we have so many combinations. So if 5 plus 2 is 7, then 3 plus 4 is also 7. So like that, what we will do? 6 plus 5, 4 plus 5, 2 plus 5, 5. Takita, takita, 6. Takita, takadakita, taka, takadakita, takadakita. Super. Now we'll play all the four, all the three together and see how music it sounds. 1, 2, 3, 4. Becomes a climax. That is the idea of playing it thrice. All the core way It's played thrice. The main climax verb is played thrice because when we play it, we play it the first time for everybody to know. Second time, the percussion artist, they come with a band understanding what we have done. And third time, it is for all of us to get together for you guys to understand. Similarly, when they play Taniya Vartanam, they do the corvette thrice. For us to, for them to play it once. Second time, we understand. And third time, it is for everybody to understand. So the corvette, we make it now.
Sometimes these corvettes, all three times, will not have the same thing. So in the first round, it will be a different symmetry. In the second one, it will be something that is matching to the first one. But slightly, there will be a variation. For instance, if it is 5-5-5, the second time it will be 7-7-7. The third time it will be 9-9-9. There should be a symmetry. So if there is an interval, the lyam is in between the space in what you increase. First, if it is 5, you have to increase the space 2 and you get 7-7-7. Then you increase the space again 2 from 7 go 9. You can't do like 5 and then 6 and then randomly do some 11. There has to be a lyam in between what you change, how you tweak it from one to the other. So now let's play the final corvette.
We are doing one corvette. Okay, for example, we'll take 5 as a number. Right?
5.
How do you do it? Start, you start.
So,
so the moment you start it like this, you know that it's a climax building up. It's a build up to a climax. So this, if you count it, it comes to 40. How do you know it is 40? Simple. 3 5s, 15. 2 5s, 10. 15, 10, 25. And then you turn it at 3 5s again. 40. 25 plus 15 is 40. So if you do this thrice, it won't come to sum. Because 40, 40, 40 is 120. We need to tweak it differently. So second time, what should we do?
We will give an interval of 9.
Oh, wow, okay. And then?
So we will repeat the 15 twice with an interval of 9.
Oh, that's beautiful. So you are adding 24, right? So next, again what you will do, you mean there is 15 thrice in between 2 nines. Let us see what happens. Huh? 1, play the corvette. 3, 4. Is 40. And then we added how much? She said we'll add 9 and then 15. So 24. 40 plus 24 is what? 64. That is 2 thala sai. Dari sa ni de. Dari sa ni de. Dari sa ni de. Dari sa ni de. Dari sa sa sa. Dari sa ni de. Dari sa ni de. So if you play the Gari sa ni de twice, if it comes to samam, it means that is the LCM. 1, 2, 3. 2 is LCM of 1, 2, 3.
So if you do the middle one, you will know if the whole thing is coming for talam or
not. You see the middle one, if it comes to samam, to samam, then that corvette, what you can do, you can play the first time once, second time twice, third time repeat the same gap. Even the gap should be the same. You cannot change the space. The 9 space should be the same. You do that twice and then add one more 15.
Shall we play what the Gurudev wants to do?
You put the taalam. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
A beautiful and a journey with Lyam forward.
We congratulate Guru Prasanna on this wonderful initiative of making everybody understand the concept of Laya in music. All the best to all of you.
Wow, that was amazing way of looking at Laya in whatever you do in music or in life, being in sync with your thought process, with your planning, with your execution and whatnot. Samatva Foundation thanks Vidwan Sri Kumaresh and Vidushi Srimati Jayanti Kumaresh for taking us through wonderful journey of Laya in both melody as well as math. Thank you so much, Anna and Akka.